The average resident of Delhi loses up to 12 years of life to air pollution.
China's air pollution has always been quite bad, and I think we have all seen pictures in places like Beijing or Shanghai where it's just the whole city is covered in dust.
India and China could not be directly compared in the view of them being at different stages of development, and also given the different sources of air pollution that contribute to the pollution problem in India and China. But I think definitely we can learn from how bad the China situation was at a particular time where India is now seeing its peak.
Three main factors there are almost always power, industry, and transport. So looking at power, China's power mix has always been characterized by a strong component of coal. And that continues to be the case today, but we see China still gradually transitioning away from coal power and also using more efficient coal power plants. And then on an industry side, China is the world's largest producer of many very polluting materials. So like cement, steel, all of these things have been characterized in China's industrial structure.
But in India, emissions are dominated by household, agricultural, dust pollutions from construction activity, vehicular emissions, landlocked regions, weather patterns, and stubble burning in the neighborhood states exacerbate the situation. Additionally, I feel inefficient waste management systems compound a lot to the issue, leading to a toxic cocktail of pollution pervading the air.
Over the last two decades, I think there are some tipping points that we saw. So one is in the Beijing Olympics. So there was a big push in terms of improving the air quality in the capital city. But we also saw in 2013 some national policies coming out, and then 2015 initiated some public discussions around air pollution as well.
This is when the local governments there in China were mandated to impose strong measure against obsolete facilities and adopt pollution control technology, and which was supported by considerable financial subsidies. If you look at our national clean air program, which was launched in 2019 to reduce the same PM2.5 concentration, the city level plan lack enforceable obligation and comprehensive governance arrangement. Not that the India government has not recognized the gravity of the air pollution crisis. It has, and it has implemented various initiatives and policies to address the pressing issue.
You see very strict enforcements when it comes to environmental issues. So we have seen politicians went down because of bad air pollution, because of bad environment policies. We have seen corporates being reprimanded. There's actually, in fact, one can argue a name and shame system happening for provinces in China. So if your province has not really met your target when it comes to energy intensity or emissions, you would actually be reprimanded by the Ministry of Environment. We think that a strong political backing, particularly from the president himself, emphasizing environmental protection, is a key reason why we see a strong improvement there. So that sort of transmits across the entire government apparatus.
Because of the China's governance structure, the stringent they have a strict enforcement mechanism in place. But in India, it depends on how at the local and the subnational level the same law is implemented and how their outcomes are.